As Dennis Matthews has written, the delicacy of expression required from the player in a movement such as the rondo of the sonata we've just heard cannot be inflated without losing the rapt, intimate mood. Solo sonatas were, in fact, seldom played in public in Beethoven's day. They were chamber music in the true sense, works for domestic sharing and enjoyment. And the radio listener today is often better off than his counterpart in the back row of the stalls, though this depends, of course, on the nature of the work being played. There are sonatas that storm the heights, like the Appassionata and the Hammerklavier, and there are others that confide, like Opus 90 and Opus 101. The sonata in A major, Opus 101, completed in 1816, has a dedication to the Baroness Dorothea von Erdmann. She was a gifted pianist, renowned for her insight and understanding of Beethoven's style. And he must surely have had her in mind when he asked for the first movement of this sonata to be played with innermost feeling, mit der innigsten Empfindung. There are two intimate movements in the work, first and the third, once described by Beethoven as impressions and reveries, and each of them is followed by a vigorously rhythmic one. The second movement, in F major, is a scherzo in the style of a march. The third, the other intimate movement, breaks off with a reminiscence of the opening of the sonata, a moment of looking back, which also serves as a lead-in to the finale. The finale is bright, assertive, delighting, and counterpoint. Again, there is a marked contrast here with the beginning of the sonata, which opens quietly, almost as though one had entered a room in the middle of a conversation.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Sonata in A Major, Opus 101 by Beethoven, played by Edith Vogel. In next Sunday's programme, she'll be playing the Sonata in B-flat, Opus 106, the Hammerklavier.